Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to solve one RL circuit problem. Okay, so transient response of RL circuit problem. For the input is a DC input. Okay, so you see this is a December 2010 and a May 2014 question. Okay, so the question is derive the expression for current in the circuit as shown in figure below. When the switch is closed at a time t equal to zero, also determine the voltage across the resistor and inductor. Okay, so already we derived the transient response of RL circuit in the previous videos. Okay, using the same procedure, we are going to derive the current flowing through this RL circuit and voltage across this resistor and voltage across the inductor. We are going to derive. Okay, so first thing. In the given question, the given condition is that we have to find out the current when the switch is closed at a time t equal to zero. Okay, what is the meaning? The switch K is closed at a time t equal to zero. Okay, before time t equal to zero, that means time t less than zero, the switch will be in open condition. Okay, so at that condition, this circuit is a open circuited mode. That's why there is no current is flowing in the circuit. So at time t equal to zero minus, the switch is in open, so the current flowing in the circuit, it will be zero. Okay, so you have to note the first thing. And at time t equal to zero, we are closing the switch. If you are closing the switch, we will get one closed path. So in this closed path, so let us assume the current flowing in this loop. Okay, you see the diagram. The diagram is the switch is in closed condition. That's why we have to consider current flowing in this RL circuit is a I of t. Okay, so now we are going to derive the value of this I of t. Okay, so how to derive the value of this I of t? We have to write a KVL equation for this loop and we have to take Laplace transform for that equation. So we have to calculate I of s. So for the I of s, we have to take inverse Laplace transform. Okay, these are all the steps. So the first one, we have to apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law to this equation, to this circuit. We will get, what is this one? The applied voltage is 60. So 60 equal to, what is the voltage drop across the resistor? 30 into I of t. And what is the voltage across the inductor? L into di of t divided by dt. So by what is the value of inductor value? 15. So 15 into di of t divided by dt. Okay. And so here, our aim is to find out this I of t. So for now, this equation, it may be solved in time domain as well as in Laplace domain. Okay, now we are going to solve this equation using Laplace transform method. Okay, so for next one, we have to take Laplace transform for the above equation. So what is the Laplace transform of the constant 60? The particular constant divided by s. Okay, it is not a 8, it is a s. Okay, so the constant value of this Laplace, the Laplace transform of this constant is 60 divided by s. And here 30 into I of t. So 30 is a constant, you keep that 30 as it is. And what is the Laplace transform of the function, time domain function small I of t? It can be written as capital I of s. Okay, plus 15 constant, you write as it is. And what is the Laplace transform of differentiation of the function I of t? So as per the property of differentiation property of Laplace transform, so the differentiation of the particular function is s into I of s. Okay, so if you are in differentiating two time means s squared into I of s. Okay, if you are differentiating one time means s into I of s. Okay, so in this equation, the left side term is having I of s as a common. So you take I of s as a common. But we have to write 30 plus 15 into s. Okay, so from this, what is our aim? Our aim is to find out this I of t. So let us rearrange this equation as I of s equal to here 60 divided by s into 30 plus 15 into s. Okay, so now we have that is the numerator thing. The numerator is in the format of s plus some value or s squared plus some value, this structure. But now here the s is multiplied with the constant 15. So you take this 15 as a outside. But if you are taking 15 from this term from outside, so we can write s plus 30 divided by 15. Okay, so what is 30 divided by 15? It is 2. And already the numerator, the constant 60 is there. Here 15 is there. So 60 divided by 15, we have to write it as a 4. So but we will get the I of s expression as 4 divided by s into s plus 2. Okay, So we got the I of s function. So in the I of s function, in numerator some constant is there. In denominator, the second order polynomial is there. Okay. So here there are two roots are there. One root is s, s equal to 0, and another one root is s plus 2. S plus 2 means the s value is minus 2. Okay. So for now, using the partial fraction expansion, we have to write this I of s function as, okay, how to, that is, what is the use of this partial fraction expansion method means, we are going to write any function as an addition of single order expressions. Okay, abhi, we have to split here, the two s term is there. So we are going to split this equation into some constant divided by the single order term s plus some constant divided by s plus 2. Okay. So now we have to find out the value of this a and b. Okay. So what is the procedure to find out the value of this a means? So the a can be written as, so what is the term available below this a? We have to write it as a s. Okay. That s term multiplied with this total left side function I of s at the condition of this s means, what is the root value of this variable s? S is equal to 0. Okay. So by a is calculated as, a ka ki, that is the denominator value s multiplied with the total function I of s at the s is equal to 0. Okay. But here s into I of s. What is I of s? The I of s is 4 divided by s into s plus 2. Okay. So you substitute the value. But here the s cancelled. So now in this expression, you substitute in the value of s, you just substitute s is equal to 0. If you are substituting s is equal to 0, we will get 4 divided by 2, it is 2. Okay. Similarly, b. So how to calculate b? So b is calculated by the s plus 2 multiplied with the total function I of s at s is equal to minus 2. Okay. So here you just substitute the value of I of s. So s plus 2 cancel. So now in the place of s, you substitute minus 2 means we will get a b equal to minus 2. Okay. So the a value, b value we calculated. So what is the next thing? We have to substitute the value of a and b in this partial fraction expansion I of s equation. So we can write the I of s equal to, instead of a, we have to put 2, and instead of b, we have to put minus 2. So we will get the equation like this. Okay. But now using that is the standard Laplace transform pair, we have to take inverse Laplace transform for the above equation. Okay. So what is the inverse Laplace transform of the capital I of s? You know, it is a small I of t. Correct. So what is the inverse Laplace transform of some constant divided by s? So already you know, for any constant, the Laplace transform value is the particular constant divided by s. But now, what is the inverse transform of some value divided by s? That some value. Okay, that constant too. And minus 2 into, what is the inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s plus a? It is a e power minus a t. Okay, in the place of a, which one is available? 2 is thing. Okay, so e power minus 2 t. Okay, so but from this, 2 is a constant. You take it outside. So we can written as 1 minus e power minus 2 t. So this is the current flowing through the RL circuit. Okay, so this is the transient current flowing through the RL circuit. So see this expression, in the current expression, we will have the value time t. Okay. So with respect to the value of t, that current flowing through the RL circuit, it is varying. Okay. It's not a constant. With respect to time, the current flowing through the RL circuit, it will be varying. That's why this response, we are calling it as a transient response. Okay. Transient response. Okay. And next one, we are going to then in the question, they asked what is the voltage across the resistor and voltage across the inductor. Okay, so the voltage across the inductor, it is calculated by, what is the voltage across the inductor formula? You know, L into di of t divided by dt. So what is the value of L given? It is 15. So 15 into d by dt of, what is I of t? So the I of t expression we already derived. 2 into 2 minus 2 into e power minus 2t. Okay. So let us differentiate these terms. The first one, you have to differentiate. If you are differentiating the constant 2 means we will get 0. Okay, then if you are differentiating the second term means the minus 2 you kept as it is. So e power minus 2t, the differentiation of e power minus 2t is e power minus 2t into minus 2. So for minus of minus plus 4. So 2 into 2, 4. So 4 into 15. So we will get the value 60. So 60 into e power minus 2t. Okay. So this is the voltage across the inductor in volts. Okay, this is the one thing. And similarly, voltage across the resistor. Okay, voltage across the resistor, it is given by voltage across the resistor equal to VR equal to R into I of t. So what is the value of R given? It is 30. What is the expression for I of t? 2 minus 2 into e power minus 2t. So you just multiply. So in this, the 30, you give it to two terms. So we will get 60 minus 60 into e power minus 2t. So if you are taking 60 as a common, we can write it as a 1 minus e power minus 2t. Okay. So this is the voltage across the resistor. Okay. This is the voltage across the resistor. So it's an important problem. So similar to such problem, they will ask in university question. Okay. This is a May 2014 question, as well as the same question it will ask in December 10 also. Okay. So this is the one. So thanks for watching.